Praise the Lord, everybody. I need everyone to turn to two or three people and tell them how blessed you are today. I need everyone to go find a visitor, please, at this time and greet yourself and introduce yourself to them and their family. Make them feel welcome because we all here are a church family, amen? We would like to encourage our visitors to our visitor center over here on the left-hand side. Over in the office so we can connect you with a life group and give you our daily schedule of our Tuesday, of our prayers and our Wednesday services. Let us have an awesome time in the Lord today.
Praise the Lord, everyone. I want to invite you to stand to your feet. Amen. We welcome you to the house of the Lord. I want you to turn to somebody. I see a few new faces, and we want to welcome every one of you here. I want the members of AJC to find somebody that's visiting. I want you to give them the love of Christ. Come on, just encourage them. Tell them it's great to be here. I'm thankful that you're here. Maybe introduce yourself to them. Amen. Spread the love of Jesus in the house of the Lord. Amen. Wonderful, wonderful. How many are thankful that you're here today? Amen. I know I'm grateful. I'm grateful that God has kept me. Hallelujah. All week long. There's been, you know, we've seen that the hand of God has been upon us, because no matter what kind of test or struggle has come against the people of God, we're here today. And because of that, we praise the Lord and we thank Him. The Bible says that there is joy in the presence of the Lord. Amen. That there is fullness of joy. And that's what we're going to declare here today. We're going to declare that we're going to trade all of our sorrows. We're trading all of our stress and worry and all the thoughts and the things that try to disrupt, amen, our lives. We're going to trade it all and give it to Jesus. And in exchange, He's going to give us His strength. Amen. And we're going to receive His joy. How many are ready to do that? Amen. I want you to just raise your hands and say, God, I want to trade everything that I have and everything that I am, Lord. And I receive all of You. I receive everything that You have for me, Jesus, because You are good. And Your mercy endures forever. God, I give You, Lord, every test, every trial, God, every doubt, every fear, every worry, Lord, I trade it now. Every sorrow, I give it to You now, Lord. And by faith, I'm going to pray. praise you, and I'm going to thank you because you are making all things work together for good. That's what Romans 8:28 says, that God is working it all out for my good. Come on, say a shout out. He's working it out for my good. It's going to be all right. I'm going to be okay in Jesus' name. Come on, lift your voice and sing, I'm trading my sorrows. Hallelujah.
Persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the earth, for His promise will endure. His joy is gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for, His joy comes in the morning. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes. persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for his promise will endure. His joy is gonna be my strength.
Though the sorrow may last,
I don't know what time you got, but it's still morning in my life.
Yeah.
Come on, give him glory. Come on, worship the King of Kings. It's morning and joy is here. His love is in the house. Hallelujah. That's why we sing. That's why we lift our voice. Oh, because his joy is here. His joy is here. Yes, it is. Say yes to it. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Say yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord.
We sing it. Rejoice in the good times and the bad. I don't know what you came in here to do, but we came to rejoice because we serve a living God, a loving God, a gracious God, a healing God, and he deserves all the glory. Come on, give him a shout of praise. Hallelujah.
There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy. There is joy. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy. There is joy.
Come on.
There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy. There is joy. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy in the house of the Lord. There is joy. There is joy. There is a river flowing. River of joy and laughter. We want to swim in the waters. We want to dance. There is a river.
There is joy.
There is joy.
that flows. Hallelujah. Come on, lift your voice. There's joy in darkness. There's joy when it looks all a mess. There's joy. Come on, lift your voice. Hallelujah.
There is joy.
Sickness
to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Discouragement. Maybe there's been oppression, depression, trying to bind you and confusion. I want you to come to the altar real quick because I feel like there's deliverance right now. And those of you that are desperate enough and you're tired of the imprisonment, you want to be delivered now. I want you to come to the altar, and there's deliverance even now. You said, God, I am not going to leave church the same way that I came. I'm tired of it. I need a change. And I need it desperately, God. I don't want to go back tied up, bound up the same way that I came. Only if you're desperate enough and you're tired of it, you're sick and tired of it, you're not going to have it anymore. Hallelujah. Come, come. The Lord has given you an opportunity to come even now. You don't have to wait for the altar call after service, but God wants to deliver and heal and set people free now. Free in your mind and heart now. Hallelujah. Just reach up and receive. Say, God, I receive deliverance. I receive healing even now, God. Heal my mind and my emotions. And as a pastor, the men of God come and lay hands on you in agreement. Hallelujah. Receive your deliverance. Hallelujah. Yes. I receive it now, God. I'm not going home the same way that I came. All these fears, God, I'm tired of them coming to haunt me, coming to try me. I want to see myself the way you see me, God. I want to see you the way you want me to see you, God. In Jesus' name, I'm going to rise up from this place free. I'm going to rise up from this place with spiritual boldness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Here I am, Lord. Minister God to the depth in me. Oh, minister God to the need in me. My need for you is great. Hallelujah. I surrender all. Yes, Lord. Just open up your heart and just tell God how you feel. Tell him how you feel and how much you need him. I need you now, God. I don't want to go home the same way that I came. Oh, Jesus. And I surrender all to you. Control and I surrender all to you. Everything I give to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing, and I give. are too weak to carry it. You and I are too weak to carry the weight of the world on our shoulders, and God knows that. So he has said, give me all of you. In Matthew 11, I believe it's verses 27 and 28, the Lord says, to take my yoke upon you. He says, come unto me, all you who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest for your souls. He says, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek, I am gentle and lowly of heart, and I'll give you rest for your souls. It's this divine exchange that God is doing even now. Jesus is lifted higher. higher than problems, higher than sickness. Oh, King Jesus, you're the name we're lifting high. Your glory shaking up the earth and skies. Revival, we want to see your kingdom here. We want to see your kingdom here. It's my desire, Lord. I want to see your kingdom here. Yes, Lord, I've got to see your kingdom.
Continue to pray. Every hand raised. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, because you pitched us from without and within. You know, when Noah was building the ark, God told him, you know what? I need you to pitch this from without and within. Because while that boat is going through that storm isn't going to go through the boat. And that's what his blood does for us. It covers us from without and within. That's why in the middle of chaos, you can stand there firm and believe. That's why in the middle of problems, through family, through life, through work, you can still stand strong. That's why people think you're crazy because you're not losing your mind. But little did they know that on that cross, there was a bloodshed that was so pure that it can heal, that it can redeem anybody. And right now, with our hands lifted up, we just want to thank you for the blood. Thank you, Lord, for the blood over my family. Thank you, Lord, for the blood over my marriage. Thank you, Lord, for the blood over my children. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Yes, Jesus, thank God for the blood. I said, thank God for the blood. Lift up your voice. Lift up your voice. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Thank you for the blood. thank you for the blood. Ashita ramo, Jesus, hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. To AJC. We can't describe it with words. We can't Facebook it. We can't Instagram it. But this is what God had in mind when he talks about corporate worship. Amen. So we thank God for AJC. We thank God for all our musicians and praise team. Going to ask the ushers if they would come up. We're going to pick up our tithes and offerings. We want to remind everyone that it's a regular schedule this week. Tuesday night prayer. Wednesday, new community. This Friday is our junior and youth service. So for all juniors and high school and college and young adults, there's a service for you on this Friday. So parents, This announcement is for you. Get your children, get your students to the house of the Lord on for this Friday. Amen. We got our student leaders, Sister Jasmine Montablo and Brother Joshua Figueroa, bringing the word, and we're just going to have a great time. Amen. And if your child needs a ride or whatnot, you just give me or my wife a call, and we'll be more than happy to go and pick them up. We're going to have a good time. Saturday, this Saturday. All the men say Saturday. Saturday. Oh, that's kind of weak. All the men say Saturday. Saturday. Say it with your chest. Saturday. There you go. Between 7 and 9 a.m., we have a general cleanup. This is our time where not only men, but our sisters and our young people could come, and we're going to help beautify the church. Amen? You can imagine how many people come through this campus every week and how sometimes it gets, running down in certain places, and it's our time to just pay attention to detail and take good care of the house of the Lord. We take good care of our houses, right? We should probably take better care of the house of the Lord. Amen? And we have an opportunity to do that this Saturday from 7 to 9. Saturday, I also want to remind you, it is our Royal Father-Daughter Ball. Amen? At 5 p.m. This Wednesday is your last day to sign up. It's $5, so it's for ages 8 to 13, so all the fathers could bring your daughters out, and for whatever reason, if the dad can't make it or if he's at work, your student pastor would be more than honored to take you to the Royal Ball. Amen? We also would like to start planning to give for Farmer's Seed. That's coming up, and if you would like to be a blessing to the church, we are reminded that our pastor will be going to Haiti, so we're asking for velos, and we're asking for tithes that we could also distribute to the people there. And we ask that today be the last day for the candy donations. We got more than enough candy to Life Haiti. I'm not going to say for a lifetime, but we're there. Amen? So thank God for that. God bless you.
no one like you, none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, none like you. We sing, our God is greater.
Our God is greater. Our God is stronger.
God, you are
higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God,
our God, our God is greater, yes. Oh, yes. God, you are, you're high and lifted up.
Our God is greater,
awesome in power. Darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you, none like you.
How great is
our God,
our God is strong, mighty and high and lifted. Oh, we sing a song of victory, 'cause he's alive. God is alive. Oh,
and if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what?
Let that be your anthem.
And if our God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what?
God is for us, then who could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what can stand?
And if God is for you, who can stand? Who can hurt you? God alone, he fights for you. Oh, again. What can stand against the kingdom of God? Nothing, nothing. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. To your circumstance. Oh, he's high and lifted up.
Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God,
our God,
our God.
Come on, give a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Give a shout of victory. Come on, he's for you. He's not against you. Oh, we worship you, Lord. We thank you for being our warrior, our fighter, our defender, our healer, our lover. We thank you, God. You're high and lifted up. High and lifted up. Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. How many are glad to be in the house of the Lord? Yeah, sounds like you're excited to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. And so glad to have everybody, every visitor. Can we give them a big round of applause? You matter. You made our day today. All you returning visitors, thank you for coming. God bless you. It's good to see Sister Elizabeth Amador's family. Amen. I won't tell you how old she has turned or she's going to turn, but it's her birthday month. And she said, I just want all my family to come with me to church. And they came. And so thank you for making your grandmother or your mother's day today. Amen. It's so good to see all new faces, returning people. These are the best moments of your life. Serving God. Amen. Coming to church and just knowing that you belong to an eternal family, that you have this potential to be part of an eternal family. It's nothing like you will ever experience. And I just want to thank everybody for coming. And next week, we'll save you a seat. If you like that seat, let me know. We will save you that seat. Amen. We want you to come back next Sunday. Amen. We would like you to come back the following Sunday. And then the Sunday after that. And just make it a habit. This is the most amazing thing in your life. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 to 18. Like our student pastor said, next Sunday, I'll be taking a red-eye flight to the country of Haiti. And we want to thank you for your prayers and your contributions. We are asking for next week, if you would like to financially support and be a blessing to the project that we are doing there in Haiti. We're actually going because we're going to be starting a Christian school in Haiti. AJC is partnering with the Apostolic Church there in Port-au-Prince, Haiti. And so I'm actually going for groundbreaking. Amen. And then we're going to go and minister to the body of Christ. So we would love for you to be part of this historic event for AJC next Sunday. Please come and already prepared. You know, I might have to give up a latte. I might have to downsize a latte. And how many know that McDonald's coffee is just as good? Amen. It's $1.05 and you've just saved $3 extra to give to Haiti. And thank you for all your contributions. As you know, it's a third world country, and we asked, what can we bring? And they said, candy. The kids, they can't afford candy. There's not a lot of candy out there. And so they look forward when a foreigner comes. They know they're bringing candy, gum, something. And so I said, okay. And so thank you all that went the day after Valentine's. Amen. It's going to be just that AJC loves you. That's why we have so many heart lollipops. Amen. And so thank you so much. Also, I know it's not in our culture, but in Haiti, it is a privilege and it is an honor for them to wear a tie to church, to go as dress. Sister Kelly's been to Kenya, and just to go in a suit and a tie is such a privilege before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And so we are taking some ties, lots of ties, to the people there in Haiti. So we're really excited about what's going on. Also, let's keep Sister Kim Lita in prayer. Sister Kim is a daughter of this church, and she got married here, and she moved to Texas with her husband. And her husband fought the good fight of faith, and he went on to be with the Lord. He fought cancer, and he went on to be with the Lord, and he leaves behind a beautiful woman of God and two small children. He was only 31. And so we ask that you keep them in praying, and we will be there tomorrow celebrating his life and being there with Sister Kim. Amen. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 to 18. I really feel like it's December and February. Amen. Seeing somebody's answered prayer. Just you coming today is somebody, you're on somebody's prayer list. Somebody has been praying for you, and you just being here today is nothing short of a miracle. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 to 18. And it says, finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Everybody say, be strong in the Lord. Amen. Be strong, not in yourself, not in your own abilities, but be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. Just turn to your neighbor and say, what are you wearing today? Amen. And then you tell them, I'm wearing Jesus. Amen. Because Jesus is my victory. Jesus is my help. Amen. In the times that I'm going through. He says, put on the full armor of God. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against rulers, against authorities, against powers of the dark world, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. I know this is before a lot of your times, but it's like Pac-Man. Right? Anybody ever play Pac-Man? Amen. And you're going to go get your fruit, but you're also running for your life because there's somebody out to kill you. Amen. That's what we're doing. We are pursuing God. We are staying in His Word. We have made some changes in our life so that we could seek after God, because there is an enemy called the devil that wants to kill you. He doesn't want to be your best friend. He doesn't want, you know, to be an acquaintance. He wants to utterly destroy you. And so therefore, put on the whole armor of God and stand firm with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, which you can extinguish all of the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, all these accessories that are so important to our walk with God. And I love verse 18. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions. That's what we've been doing. We've been praying because that is our strength. That's where our source comes from. We need God like we need the very breath that we take. With this in mind, be alert and always keeping on praying for the Lord's people, because you're not the only one going through what you're going through. Don't your neighbor say, you're not the only one. Amen. You're not, the enemy would like you to, you know, that's why we're depressed, because we think we're the only one going through what we're doing. But in all reality, somebody else is going through the same thing. They're going to fight in prayer for you. I want to preach for a few moments on glasses, jelly beans, and sunblock. Amen. Glasses, jelly beans, and sunblock. Amen. I think that's the way you're going to remember this week. Glasses, jelly beans, and sunblock. You may be seated. You don't have to raise your hand, but how many of you depend on sunblock? Like before you leave, it's like, devil is a liar. You know, UV rays, I ain't getting skin cancer. And, you know, so, you know, you. Because whether we put on sunblock or not, it doesn't change the fact that we are all acceptable to sunblock. Hey, wow, praise the Lord. Somebody does carry sunblock. Amen. And so whether we like it or not, we have to put on sunblock to keep us away from harmful rays. It's amazing how many people will go day after day without reading God's word, praying, or fully depending on God's help to help us in times of trouble. The Bible says for us to be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. If there's ever a time, is now, that we can't afford to be only dependent on our feelings. But we need to be founded on the Word of God and in prayer. Israel wasn't going to win Jericho by their weapons. It was God that was going to bring the victory. And we need to walk and we need to pray in the Spirit of God. Because God is our victory. And God is our strength. Outside of Him, we are living in a very sensitive time that there's so much hatred, there's so much division, there's so much violence, there's such chaos everywhere you go. I mean, it's blue skies. What? They protest that it's blue skies. I mean, people nowadays, they are just mad and livid at the world. And those attitudes and those spirits of anger and violence goes out into our streets. And not only into our streets, but it tries to invade our homes. But I thank God, and I am assured that the church will always be victorious. That the church will always be stronger than whatever situation is around us. That whatever attack from the enemy, we are confident in 1 John chapter 4 and verse 4 that says, "You are from God and have overcome them, because the one who is in you is greater than the one that is in the world." Amen. And so we have an assurance that God is with us. Amen. And so we got to be living with the mindset that God is our strength, that God is our help, that I cannot do anything without God's help and without His word. It is His word that gives us wisdom. It is His word that gives us joy in the midst of whatever we're going through. It's His word that sustains us when the storms of life comes. Somebody might say, "Well, why are you praising God and why are you guys so excited when you're going through some things?" And I want to let you know that yes, we do have storms in life. Yes, we do got problems. And yes, we are in the midst of the storm. We might be wet, but our boat isn't sinking. I wonder if there's anybody that can testify that yes, you're going through a middle of divorce. Yes, the doctors have given you a bad report. Yes, your children are going through some addictions. But you got assurance that your boat is not sinking. Man. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 4 says, "For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds." The devil is real. His plans are to destroy your family. There's every time we need to pray for our families is now. You know why? Because if you split an atom, it's explosive. If you split a marriage, it will destroy everything. I know Hollywood doesn't teach you that. I know your little novels, especially novellas, don't teach you. But let me tell you something. Once the marriage is split into two, it is an explosive situation that affects everybody around us. Amen. So the enemy is out to destroy, number one, your mind. Everybody say, "My mind." Because if he could get to your mind, he could get into every part of your life, because your mind controls everything that you do. Amen. Whatever controls your mind controls your life. Amen. If there's somebody that is religious and you're used to other preachers that just say, you know, some things that are just too nice, well, this is the wrong preacher. So I'm going to say some things that you might say, "Ouch," or "Oh my goodness," but it's because we love you. Because God is reaching down to the depths of your heart. I would hate to go to an oncologist and I have a tumor, a 50-pound tumor on the side of my neck that is cancerous. And he says, "You know what? It's okay. It's okay. It's going to be okay. Just continue to
live, and you know, we won't do treatment because it's going to be okay. It's not even cancer. But yet the reports say it's cancer. Let me tell you something. You better thank God that the Word of God reveals areas in our lives that we need to get rid of, that we need to change. We better thank God for the Word of God. And so the Word of God is telling us, the Spirit of God is telling us, if there's anything we need to protect in the hour that we're living in, is our mind. Because you just watch the news for 20 minutes and you're going to have an anxiety attack. I mean, you just watch, you know, people's propaganda and just, you know, you hear people, there's just chaos going all throughout the world. And if we are not alert to what's going on in our environments, it will affect our life. So when the enemy comes in to attack your mind, when the enemy comes in to, you know, bring lies to and fear to your mind, you cannot beat him with fear. You cannot beat him with worry. You cannot beat him with laziness. You cannot beat him with food. You cannot beat him with just with television or the gym. The only thing that's going to beat the devil is truth. That's in the Word of God. Amen. If you try to fight the devil in your flesh, you will lose. He's strategic. He's a spiritual being. And he's also strong. He's stronger than you. But he's not stronger than our God. Amen. And when you got Jesus in you, you are stronger than the devil. Amen. We must be powerful in walking with God, to put on the whole armor of God so we can fight the devil for our mind. Because if the devil can get into our mind, he can control every part of your life. Romans chapter 8 and verse 6 says, now the mind of the flesh is death, but the mind of the Spirit is life and peace. How many want life and peace? You got to get the right mind. You got to start thinking the right thoughts. You got to start knowing God's word so that when fear and when worry and when chaos tries to overtake you, because we got so many people nowadays, you know, that are battling suicide, that is battling antidepressants, that are bound by craziness, that is bound by some things that are going on. I was just so my heart was just, you know, it was like a dagger that hit it when a friend of mine said, pray for my sister who had to be admitted to, a mental institution because something's just not right. Something's not going on, you know, right going on in her mind. And she's 14. The mind that we have, it's so beautiful. It's so amazing when it's clear, when it has clarity of what God wants to do in our lives and through in our lives, and it brings such a peace. If it is not filled with the things of the Spirit, it is chaotic. It is filled with worry and fear. It is filled with you know, speculations and imaginations. But we got to discipline our mind, because it is where the devil fights us every day at all times. Man, you know why your mind is so important? Because it's the thoughts that go through your mind that produces the lens in which you see everything. So if you are fearful in your thoughts that you're going to die early, something bad is going to happen to you, your husband is going to cheat on you, he's not coming home today, your kid's going to be ran over by a bus on his way to, you know, on his way home from school, you're going to die of, you know, this incurable, you know, disease. I mean, all kinds of things going on. I wonder who my daughter's going to marry. She's only 3 years old. And once you allow these thoughts into your mind, it becomes the lens of how you see everything. How you think and the thoughts that you allow in your mind are the lens of how you perceive everything that you do. That means everything that you do is based off fear. Because you have allowed fear to come into your mind. If you allow thoughts of offense and unforgiveness to come into your mind, like nobody likes you, that person doesn't like you, nobody likes you, you are unlikable, you will be alone, you will be by yourself for the rest of your life. Every time you look through the lens, every time you see somebody, you are offended. I mean, they could smile at you and you'd be like, oh, I don't like that smile, I'm so offended, I can't believe they even smile. I mean, like any little thing, you get offended. Because it's the thought processes. This is the importance of having a healthy mind. Because when you have a healthy mind, you're able to perceive things like God. If you do not have a healthy mind, then you perceive things like the flesh, which is worry, anxiety, unforgiveness, being easily offended, just, you know, living tormented by the work of the flesh. This is why every day we need to put on the armor of God. And the first thing that we must put on is the belt of truth. Everybody say the belt of truth. Amen. Everybody say the belt of truth. Yeah, you better make sure every day of your life you have the belt of truth on, because it is the belt of truth that is going to be able to help you process what thoughts should come in and what thoughts should not come in into your life. The mind is the most important thing. Let's not even talk about your marriage, your children, your parenting skills. Let's not even talk about the anxiety that you're going through. Let's talk about what is going through your mind right now. Amen. Let's not even talk about the problems, you know, that your house is going through, that your finances are going. Let's talk about your mind, because it's what, how you're perceiving, it's how you're thinking that you're able to react to these situations. And so, number one, you need to feed your mind with truth. Everybody say with truth. John chapter 8, verse 32 says that you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Amen. The problem is we feed our mind too much junk food. I'm just so ugly. I hate this job. My kids, I mean, it's like junk food. Junk food thinking. My mom's so horrible. Nobody loves me. I'm enjoying these jelly beans. That's not the sermon, but, you know, even though how tasty these jelly beans are, especially the combination of all these flavors, it's junk food. Because it has no nutritional value in my life. It is pure sugar. Can you imagine if me and RJ were going to have a UFC fight? Come on, have some faith in me. I'm eating jelly beans, watching TV all day. Josh, our student pastor, is my trainer. He said, you know what? Instead of running, let's go have Mr. T's. Let's have a donut. He's running like 5 miles a day, vegetarian, 300 push-ups in, 3 minutes? Who do you think is going to win? I might have the muscles. Come on, help me. I'm perceiving good right now. Amen. Right, honey? Yeah. But I don't got the stamina to outlast him. I'm going to be winded. I want to tell the believers here today, you need to outlast the devil. And therefore, you need to process through your mind, are these thoughts helping me? Because I need to perceive what is truth. And what isn't truth, I need to not pay attention to it. Amen. Any of you ever been down the freeway and somebody cuts you off and you're like, first thing you see, first thing you ask, is the AJ sticker on my bumper? If not, it's going down, right? That doesn't, it doesn't make you a bad person. It's a thought. It's a thought. And then you put K-Love. Like, in Jesus' name, and then you pass him up, and the initial thought doesn't make you a bad person. It's when you entertain it. Come on, somebody. And so the enemy every day, how many like fishing? Right? So, you know, in order to get a good fish or even a fish, you got to have what? Bait. All right? And you throw it out there and you keep throwing it and you keep until here comes the little fish and it bites on the bait. What do you do next? Yeah, little sucker, you're coming. You're coming home tonight. Every day, the enemy is like the fisherman. He's feeding you. Nobody likes you, Roman. Nobody likes you. You are all by yourself. And then Roman has his Bible, and he says, God's word says, don't ever leave me nor forsake me. I am more than a conqueror. Okay, I'm not even playing around with you. And so then the devil comes around. Sister Geneva, man, you are a horrible person. And right away, what happens? I mean, first little thought is like, and then he just starts feeding her more and more. You got to learn that it's just a thought, and you don't have to give into it. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, you don't have to give into that thought. Amen. You don't have to give into the lies of the enemy. Amen. You don't need to feed your mind on junk food and things that are not true. You got to feed your mind on truth. And what is truth? God is with me. God is doing a great work. God is setting up America for the greatest revival. Amen. But it's how we filter what we're going through based off our mind. Amen. Feed your mind on truth. Our thoughts control our life. Therefore, you need to get your thoughts lined up to God's word. Amen. You need to get it aligned to God's word. Not to Hollywood. Come on. Not to how many likes on Instagram. You need to get your life aligned to God's word. What does God say about you? What does God say about your future? Behold, I know the plans that I have for you. Jeremiah 29:11. This says the Lord, it is plans of a future. Come on, somebody. It is good thoughts. It is a good future. It's a future of an expected end. That means, guess what? I know the end of my life, and that is I will be with God for all eternity. I want to just write this down. Your beliefs do not shape your life. Amen. I'm sorry, your feelings. Everybody say, my feelings. It doesn't shape my life. My beliefs do. Amen. We all get feelings. We all have moments that we want to give in to the jelly beans. We have moments that we want to change our glasses of positivity into, come on, your mom's negative. No, we won't even go there. We won't even go there. But it's like you want to stop being a good person. You want to stop, serving God. You want to stop living God according to his word. And you want to put down those lands and you want to think, right? Because it's always good when you're depressed and you have a bucket of ice cream. Feels good. It's comfort food. We like to be victimized many times. Because we have excuses. We could blame, our past. We could blame what somebody did to us. But it's hard to be victorious because there's nobody to blame. Amen. But your feelings don't shape your life. Let me tell you something. The children of Israel, Goliath shows up and he tells them, I'm going to kill all of you. Nobody's stronger than me. Nobody can beat me. And I'm coming after you. And for 40 days, guess what? They heard the words of Goliath. They heard him intimidating us, him bringing fear upon our thoughts. And therefore, they saw through their lens fear. And they hid in a tent, and they were afraid of their life because they believed in their mind what Goliath was saying about them. But David came onto the scene, and he had different lens. He had a different mindset. When he saw Goliath, he said, hey, that's not a big giant. My God is bigger than this giant. I wish I had somebody just to remind America, there's still revival. These are our best days. We're not going to allow the enemy to divide us. We're not going to allow race to destroy us. We're not going to allow political parties to stuff their agenda down. We got a solution. His name is Jesus, and we're going to have revival until the rapture. Real quick, is there a David in this house that will stand upon your feet and say, there's still hope for my marriage. There's still hope for my family. There's still hope for America. Amen. David looked at Goliath and he said, your words do not intimidate me. I was telling my wife on our way to the AM service, I said, there's a belief that I have that's stronger than any, it's part of all my other core beliefs. Just like I believe in the rapture of the church, I believe Jesus died and was buried and rose again, that here, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and water baptism in this precious name of Jesus, like Acts 2:38 in the early church, and just like as I'm convicted of the outpouring of the Holy Ghost, and just as I'm convicted about taking communion in remembrance of him, I said there's one that I is just as strong, and that is God is good all the time. I said, that's part of my doctrine, that God is good in the good times, in the bad times, when the enemy is saying you're going to die young, your marriage is going to fall short, your church is not going to have revival. I can look back and tell the devil, I command you in the name of the Lord to get behind me, because the God that I serve is good, and he gives me good gifts. He gives me good blessings. 30 seconds out, somebody celebrate that the Lord, he is good.
Come on, somebody. Every situation I look, God is good. Behold, he will take a bad situation and he's working it out for my good, because God is a good God. High five someone and say, God is good. Come on, God is good. I don't care if the devil's saying you're fat, you're ugly, you're good for nothing, this marriage is going to fall apart, you're going to die of an incurable disease. You need to tell the devil all you've done, because I don't believe one word that is coming out of your mouth. I serve a God that is good.
Amen. Right, because you start worrying. What are you going to have for dinner tomorrow? What's on the menu for dinner? Oh, my gosh. I don't even have pinto beans. Oh, my God. Then I'm going to have to go buy pinto beans. And then how many hours are they going to be on? I don't even think I have time. And we're stressing out about dinner tomorrow, when we're enjoying the presence of God. And then all of a sudden you're like, oh my goodness. And then the kids have a project in 3 weeks. And then, oh my God, I got to pay bills on the 1st of March. And then all of a sudden your body starts acting up, and then your whole left side goes numb. You go, oh my God, I'm going to die. I'm going to have a heart attack. No, it's your anxiety. Come on, it's your stress. You're stressed out about things that you cannot control. And let me tell you something. God is reminding you, yes, you cannot control, because I am in control and I am your God. Don't you worry about tomorrow. Don't you worry about next week. Don't you worry about next year. Your life is in my hands and I'm going to take. I wish I had somebody. The moment your mind starts going south, you need to remind it. It's okay. I'm in the hands of my God.
Amen. Could you imagine if you put as much energy as you do in worrying and complaining and cheesy meandering, if you could put that same energy in praising God? Can you imagine? You could put that same energy, instead of breaking your ex-husband's window, if you could say, devil, I thank God where I'm going.
Man, you got to learn where to put your energy. Because the warfare that is going on for your mind is not one of the flesh. Is it not something you can do? You got to be led by the Spirit of God. You got to be prayed up, and you need to ask God, give me direction and give me guidance, because if it's me and the devil in the match, I'm going down. But if it's the devil, me, and God in the match, the devil has already been defeated. Come on, somebody. And so I need to get this. I wish somebody would lay your hand on your mind and say, I'm not going anywhere but where God has for me, and his plans over my life, they are good. My 30 seconds, I dare you to stand upon your feet. Where's the David in this house? Devil, you're going down. Depression, you're going down. Fear. God is good.
You're like, nah, you're making too much noise. Let me tell you something. When you're at happy hour, when I'm picking your little butt up at 2 a.m. while you're parting up your worries, this is it. This is how I do it. This is how I get my mind in order. When I think of the goodness of Jesus. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, God is good. 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 God is good.
That's him, Neil. You keep on running. God is good. My family's going to be saved. I ain't worried about death. I'm going to live my greatest life right now. Amen. God is good. I'm not alone. Church, you even say, you're not alone. That is a truth that I believe in. Listen, if you live off feelings, you ain't going to go nowhere. Amen. If you live off feelings, you're going to be an emotional wreck. You're up today, gone tomorrow. You're happy today, you're sad tomorrow. I'm like bipolar. But this joy is not determined by what happens to me or what doesn't happen. It's the assurance that the presence of God is with me. Whether I'm in the valley, whether I'm in the mountaintop, whether I got money, whether I don't got money, I got truth. And my reaction is based on truth that he'll never leave me. High five somebody and say, you're not alone. You are not alone. This week you need to feed on truth. You need to feed on truth. You need to eat the goodness of the Lord. I am loved. I am beautifully and wonderfully created by God himself. I was created in the image of God. Amen. Whether it was in his chubby moment, his skinny moment, his not feel so good moment, I was created in his image. Amen. And I am loved by him. Don't you let the thought, come on somebody, come into you and say, nobody loves you. You're all by yourself. Get that gun. Get those pills. Come on, somebody. Don't you allow the devil to tell you that you will never be accepted and belong in the house of the Lord. You need to put on your lens of thinking right and say, I am loved by God himself. High five, five people say, I am loved, I am loved, I am loved. Man. I am loved, I am loved. I don't see giants, I see how big God is. I don't see giants, I see how great and how big my God is. That's what we need to see, maybe see. It's a mind thing. It's a mind thing. You may be seated. Almost done. Like, wow, that was an awesome finale. No, God ain't done yet. Amen. We need to get ourselves prayed up. This week, you need to feed on the truth of God. You need to read God's word and you need to read his promises. Amen. Don't you believe that the lie one bit, I'm going to die single, ain't nobody. Yeah. You tell the pastor, I need a hookup, I need it now. I'm being honest, pastor. I said, okay, well, we're going to hook you up. The Lord's going to lead us. Amen. No, amen. Somebody said, amen, pastor. Hook me up. I got a cousin right now. He's single. He's on fire for the Lord. Julian Amador. Amen. Raise your hand, Julian. My, there he is. He's here today. Has a good job. Owns his own home. Has a car. Come on, somebody. Man, I'm just saying. Just saying. What gets us all the time is our junk food thinking. Because this is just the beginning of how you see things.
However you see things is because you're allowing. Perfect example. I don't know. Remember Fabio? I don't know people nowadays who's cute, who's pretty, but you remember Fabio, long blonde hair. And so, first the enemy will give you thoughts of Fabio in your head, sisters. Well, even brothers nowadays, you know. But listen, okay? Temptation. Fabio, Beyonce, whatever, your thoughts will come in. Let me tell you something. That doesn't define who you are. You might like that coworker that like gets on you and you're like, oh, I could go from Holy Ghost to hood real quick. And if she gives me enough time to take off these bobby pins, it's going down. Is going down. But let me tell you, see, in the midst of that process, you need to think about the goodness, you need to think about the word. And say, is that aligning myself up to the word of God? Because 2 Corinthians says to bring down every thought into captivity and bring it to the obedience of God. You got to say, is this the right thought? Does this thought align to the word of God? And if it doesn't, I need to let it go. I need to put it back in the junk food spot. We hosted a district event yesterday, and we had all this candy, and we had some left over. I got home, and it's on the kitchen. I said, oh, my gosh, this is wrong. All this sugar. We need to. Literally, we're like, we're going to throw it out in the garbage because unless you want jelly beans, you can take it home today. Amen. Free of charge. But you got to keep your mind aligned to the word of God. Men and women, we all have light temptations. We all are faced with things in our life, and it varies on different areas, but we need to align it to God's word. And if you feel sad, if you feel worried, if you feel like you are by yourself and nobody loves you, let me tell you something. It is a great inclination that you are not feeding on truth, because God will always tell you, you are my daughter, you are my son, I love you, you are not alone in this race. Everybody say, feed off truth, the truth of God. This is not your time to be thinking about something that is not found in the word of God. This is your time that you rise up and you say, I believe God, not my feelings. I believe God that I could be a great husband. I am on my way. I'm not where I should be, but thank God I'm not where I used to be, and I'm okay with that. And I'm on my way to be a better person. I'm on my way out of addictions. I'm on my way out of these strongholds in my mind. And you know what? I wish you would just turn to your neighbor and give him a round of applause and say, I'm glad you made it today. Come on, I'm glad you made it today, because if you only knew what I was going through, you would be, praise God, double time. But I thank God, because the same devil that is trying to kill me is trying to kill you, but we made it to the house of the Lord. Church, we got to change our mindset. Because everything and how we perceive, how we're thinking is based, how we're seeing things is based off what we're thinking. And the first thing that we have to do is we got to depend on God to help us. Sin is sin. Whether you steal staples from your work or you do some other crazy sins, let me tell you something. We all need a Savior. And we all come from different walks of life. We all come from different parts of this road. But I want to tell you something. There is hope tonight. You are not who you are based on how you feel. You're not who you are based off what happened to you, what's going on around you. You are what you are because God said, you are my son. You are my daughter. And I'm not going to leave you. I'm not going to give up on you. And yes, you're not perfect, but that's why I came and I died on a cross. And I want you to depend on me like never before because your mind, once it starts going in different directions, there's so much confusion. I want you to place your head on your hand on your head. Come on, church, we got a society that's just so in chaos right now. We got a society right now that is just anything can set them off. And it's coming knocking at your door. It's coming knocking at your marriage. There's so much evil that wants to invade your thought processes, and you have to filter it out and say, is this what God says I am? Is this who God really says I am? Am I doing what I was created to do by God? I want to tell everybody from the balcony all the way to the front row, you being here today, this is what Jesus demonstrated on the cross. He gave us a life. He gave us an opportunity so that we can serve him, that we can love him, that we can find hope in time of hopelessness. I want to help everybody in this house, and some of your struggles in your personal life is based off your thought processes, and God wants to help you think different. Everybody say, God is good. I am loved by God himself. I am not alone, and I am victorious. Because Jesus conquered death and the grave. You need to feed on that all week. You need to feed on that all week. God is good. God is good. I'm not alone. I'm not alone. I'm not alone. I'm not alone. You need to accept that. Friend, God wants you just to accept that you are loved by him, and that fatherly love that he wants to demonstrate in your life, you got to be okay with that, because there's some times where you are just seeking for that approval, you're just seeking for that confirmation, and God's saying, I'm always there. And by you just having a breath of life, it's just a reminder. That is an affirmation that he has given you his breath for another day so that he could demonstrate his love for you. Why don't you just raise your hand right now in the name of Jesus. I receive the love of God. I receive it like never before. I'm not alone. In the name of my Father, he's proud of me. I am on my way to a better place in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Cassie, give me a high five. Love you, girl. You are awesome. You being here today, man, I could just imagine what you had to get through to get here, but I'm glad that you put in your mindset, I'm going to get to the house of God. Good for you. Brother Vasquez, God reminded you today that it's not where you were, it's where he's taking you. He says, get ready, because your best days are here. They're not coming, they are here.
And you just need to keep two eyes focused in the present, in the future. He says, not where you are, where you were, it's where you're going. In the name of Jesus. Church, there is hope tonight because God is speaking to our lives. It's not just coming to church, it's the ability to persevere. It's the ability to have the stamina to stand when life is trying to knock us out. Do you have the ability to stand? Do you have that confidence that God is with me? And whether it be a fiery furnace, whether it be whatever is being thrown at me, I have truth buckled in my spirit that I am not alone. We're so glad you're here. I see the glow of God all upon you. And you are going to pave the way for such a generation of girls that people in their family might not be connected to the things of God, but their relationship with the Heavenly Father is so connected. And you have things that so many people that have parents in the church, they lack. That there's a connection. Even without parents bringing you to church, there's something deep rooted in you, and that's, I made a choice to serve the Lord for the rest of my life. And there is nothing like it. It's not what you feel, it's what you believe. What you believe tonight. What you believe to be truth. Because that is your reality. I want you to raise your hand all throughout this house. I know life is falling apart all around you, and I know all your years you've been just lied on. You just allowed deposits of junk thoughts to be deposited in your life. Maybe it was from your mother, from your father, from just people. But God's telling you today, you are my beloved. And I love you. And what I'm about to do in your life, you're going to conquer giants. And those things that was supposed to be there to kill you, you're going to use it to kill it. Because God is with you. In the name of Jesus. I love this family, right? Several years ago, they lost their father. But look at God's just restoring. One after another. One after another. Yes, you lost so much. But God said, I'm going to give you so much more. I'm going to give you so much more for what you lost. In the name of that's it. Because he's the only one that can replenish. He's the only one that can restore. And what was lost, God said, I'm going to give you more. Come on, somebody give God a big round of applause. And if you know that the Lord is good, why don't you stand up on your feet, clap your hands, and say, I believe it. I believe that the goodness of God is going to follow me all of the days of my life, that I am not alone, that even though my father walked out on me, though somebody left me, God never left my side. And this is the truth. I choose to believe truth. I want everybody to pretend to put on glasses. What are you seeing through those? Come on, everybody participate. You look awesome. Some act like I got big old. I got old eyes. Listen, what are you seeing? Are you seeing just offense, hopelessness because fear has played your mind? Do you sense like just feel so insecure? I don't feel secure in any area of my life.
you see trouble? Do you anger? Do you see through anger? Do you see through unforgiveness? So everything is based off unforgiveness. Every response, every part of your life is based off unforgiveness. I'm going to tell you something. Don't you let that person rob you from what God has for you right now. Don't you wait for an apology. Don't you wait for somebody to come knocking at your door and say, forgive me. Right now, you got to live. You got to choose to forgive. You got to choose to throw down those lens of unforgiveness and say, it starts now. I'm going to start living in forgiveness so I can love. I can love the people that are left in my life. Some of you look into lens of unforgiveness, of condemnation. But you don't know what I did, Pastor. You don't know my past. You don't know my wrong. You don't know all my shortcomings. One more time, everybody, look through those lens. At the count of three, I want you just to slam them down. I want you to just slam them down right now, because God's going to give you a new mindset. God's going to see a good, give you a new way of looking at life and looking at things. And just because your grandma divorced and your mom divorced, God is going to sustain your marriage. God is going to keep your marriage. You got to say, it ends today. My ugly thinking, my ugly mindsets, right now, by the authority of God's word and by the power that is in the name of Jesus, I speak liberty and deliverance in this house, that how we used to see, we're not going to see it no more, because God is going to renew our mind and we're going to perceive different right now. 1, 2, 3, come on, throw them down. Throw them down. Throw them down. Throw them down. Shatayalabaka. Some of you need to step on it. Fear no more. I will not be bound to fear. I will not be bound to unforgiveness. I'm free. I'm free. I'm free. I'm free. Anxiety, I'm free. Depression, I'm free. Fear of being abandoned again, I'm free. I'm free. There it is. Every hand raised right now. Yarabakai, there is deliverance in this house. God's gonna step in to be your father right now. He's gonna guide you, he's gonna lead you. Feelings determine how you live. Let your beliefs. God is with me. God is for me. God is in me. Now I'm going to challenge everybody all throughout this house. If you can get out to the aisleway, get to this altar. I want to pray for everyone. I want you to worship God. I want you just to feed off truth right now. That's worship. I want you just to feed off truth. I want you to feed off the goodness of God. I'm not going to fear tomorrow. I'm not going to fear abandonment. Nobody's walking out on me. Nobody. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, God is with me every day, every moment. Well, we got to be spiritual, church. We got to place God first. We got to pray, put prayer in the word above all things. He says, this doesn't come out unless you pray and you fast. I want to tell you something. Come on, church. You need to turn out some things and you need to get connected to God. And you say, God, I need a new mindset. I need to think different. I need to react different. No more holes in the wall. No more running away. No more struggles of fighting of what God wants to do in my life in the name of Jesus. Now come on, raise your voice. I'll drop this out. You free, free, free. Free.
Before you leave, I want everybody, if you got the Holy Ghost, pray in other tongues. Come on, let's do 2 minutes. Come on, everybody, just raise your voice. There are visitors, some receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost, some being renewed with the gift of the Holy Ghost. I want you all throughout this house.
Hallelujah.
It says, above all,
you are
be strong in the Lord and the power of His Spirit. That is the beginning of all things. You need to get so connected by the Spirit of God, by His power. There it is. There it is. Come on. Come on. Strongholds are being broken. People are being delivered. Now. You can't fight it in your flesh. You cannot destroy yokes of bondage by yourself. It has to be through the Spirit of God. Fullness of joy right now. Just rejoice in His presence.
If you want to clap, come on. That's it. Let this be a revelation.